Why is consciousness involved with form, definition, impermanence, identification with this, etc.? Because it wants to learn how to die. Why does it want to learn how to die? Because that's the only way that plausibly it can imagine becoming prime creator. In other words, it has to destroy what it is. Because what it is the creation of the prime creator. That's what it is. So it has to get rid of what it is in order to imagine that it can become something else, which is prime creator. So consciousness, that's the purpose. Where did all this impermanence come from? It is a training exercise that mind has designed for spirit, so spirit can learn how to die. Spirit doesn't know how to die. There's no death for spirit. There's no death in reality. There's no such thing at all. So this is all just an invention, a whimsical invention. Like, oh yeah, there's a way to die. And so mind is presenting this training program for spirit. And so spirit is busy working on this training program. And mind says, come on, hurry up, hurry, hurry up. It's not working. Spirit hasn't learned it yet. And mind says, spirit, you're not going fast enough. You know, you got a limited amount of time here. You got to really concentrate your efforts. So mind presents it, this training program, in such a way as you're under pressure to learn how to die. A lot of pressure. So we're feverishly, you know, trying to engage in lifetimes and compressing everything as much as possible to increase the intensity. We're trying to increase the intensity. Now, the Holy Spirit, which God created to deal with the continuity problem, and the continuity problem being that we're so accustomed to this training program, which is completely foreign and unlike, shares no commonality with reality whatsoever, we're terrified to drop the training program because we feel we'll be eternally disoriented. We not only disoriented, but so disoriented that we can't reorient ourselves to reality. So we're terrified of dropping the training program. We want to succeed at it. We want to, and if we can't succeed, we want to stay with it forever. We want to stay with it. And the mind says, yeah, you can stay with it forever. You just have to improve it, make it more enjoyable for yourself. And ultimately the mind says, but you can succeed, you will succeed, and then you don't need to go back to reality. So there's no worry about continuity problem. That's what the mind is telling spirit. The Holy Spirit is a creation of God specifically to solve the continuity problem, because God knows this training program won't work. Spirit can't learn how to die, and it will never be satisfied with dwelling in this training program. It wants to drop it and accept reality as it is, and it will do that. That's what it wants. It can't get rid of that longing for reality. It's impossible. So the only answer for spirit is to solve the continuity problem. Spirit has one problem. That's the continuity problem. There are no other problems. When you wake up in the morning and your dreams are all over the place and you think, oh, there's this problem, this problem, this problem. I found the greatest help to center yourself on the day is to repeat, there's only one problem. This isn't the problem. This isn't a problem. Whatever arises a problem, say, this isn't a problem. There's only one problem. That's the continuity problem. And then everything clicks into place and you feel centered on spiritual truth just like that. I did it this morning. I couldn't focus my mind. What do I think about today? What do I think about? I said, wait a minute, there's only one problem. And then everything came back into focus. OOP. Whoops. I've forgotten. Oops. Oh, only one problem. Oops, I have a problem. Only one problem. There's another, an acronym. These are helpful. Little techniques you use like this. Whoops, I've forgotten. Oops. Oops, 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 I've forgotten. Wait, whoops, only one problem. There's only one problem. Continuity problem. Because without the continuity problem, we would again drop the training program this instant. Without any hesitation, we would drop it. So the entire training program would vanish because it's only being imagined. It's only a hallucination. So there wouldn't be any problem The flesh would vanish, the universe would vanish, everything would vanish. Poof. No problem. And we'd be in, realize we're in reality, and there's no problems in reality at all. So we only have one problem. So what's the answer to that problem? That, see, that centers your thought. Right away, you're centered. Whoops, I forgot. What have I forgotten? Oops. Oh, only one problem. Only one problem. So, but the mind is trying to pressure us with time. It's saying, come on, you see, this death is happening fast. It's fast. It's coming at you fast and furious. And that's the mind wants to have death coming at you fast and furious. Overwhelm you with death. Death everywhere, everywhere, right now. Fires, you know, comets, tsunamis, everything. Death's piling down on you. More and more and more and more and more. That's its goal, to teach you. Now, the Holy Spirit doesn't attack our desires, our training program. It doesn't attack anything. It lets us keep our basic orientation, okay? But how I see it is that what the Holy Spirit does is say, okay, you want to learn how to die. Okay, I'm not attacking that. But the Holy Spirit knows you would drop that in a sec, instantly, if there wasn't a continuity problem. Okay, so it doesn't attack that, the desire to die. Say, okay, you want to learn how to die. Fine. You have a training program. All these things. Fine. Fine, fine, fine. What we're going to do, Holy Spirit says, is we're going to say that this death that you're trying to learn, this learning process, okay, that you're trying to learn, the Holy Spirit says, okay, I'll take care of this learning process now, but we are going to have this learning process be spread out over unlimited quantities of time. So a trillion to the trillionth, trillionth power doesn't even begin to define the amount of time that we're going to spread this out. Okay, so as you look right now, the Holy Spirit says, as you look right now, do you see any, are you identifying with any death? Because we are identifying with things that are dying. Everything is dying, things. But perception is identifying with that. And we are defining it as a death, so to speak. We're defining it. And I'm defining more and more and more and more and more, quicker, quicker, quicker. But we don't have to actually define it like that. So, by not identifying with all these definitions of death and saying, oh, well, this is a process that is spread out over boundless quantities of time, actually. So what we then perceive right now, we cannot see the slightest trace of death anywhere, because it's in our now new time frame, it's so taking place so slowly that even a trillion years of looking for it, we still can't even notice even the beginning of it. And yet theoretically it is still there. It's just, you know, going at a snail's pace, as it were. So, in that case, perceptually, we say, well, yeah, I know I have this program, and it's there for me. It's there for me. The program is still there for me. It's just I don't see evidence of the learning taking place. I don't see any evidence of the learning taking place at this point, but I know it's spread out, that's okay. So perceptually, there's no trace of it, not even any trace. So we can have our cake and eat it too. We say, oh, the training program's still here. All the stuff I've used for that is still here. It's just that I don't see a trace. I know conceptually it's there, but perceptually, I'm not able to see even the slightest trace of death. It's not touching me. I'm not being touched by the training program yet. Eventually, it could touch me, but it's not touching me at all right now. So then, by simply experiencing that right now, I'm not being touched by it at all. You get used to this by not being touched by death. You get used to it, and once you get used to it, you've overcome the continuity problem, because you say, oh, well, it's easy to go into reality, because reality, I'm not being touched by death either. And the only difference is just a whim, difference between a whim and no whim. And the continuity problem gets dissolved in this way. So you might say, the Holy Spirit, when you turn time over to the Holy Spirit, there's a sense that you're not being touched by death at all. But you still feel that nothing's been taken away from you. Nothing's been attacked. You still say, well, if I want to, I can hang in there with this training program for, you know, trillions and trillions and trillions and trillions and trillions to the trillionth, trillionth. You know, I can hang in there. And if I want to, and I can go through the training if I want to. There's no guarantee it'll work, of course. But the program is still there. Of course, it'll never work, but the program is still there. So the Holy Spirit doesn't take the program away from us. It's still there, except now the time frame has changed. The time frame. You put a different frame around it. Time frame. So you could say, well, I'm not being touched by any sense of death or any sense of suffering. Or any sense of misery. There's no sense of that taking place at all. Now we think, of course it's there, of course there's suffering, misery, etc. But it's actually how we're defining it that's there. It's our definitions, and it's our time frame that's there. Our definitions are based on our time frame of what we want to accomplish. This is pretty interesting here. So we're assuming, well, the body is what I am, but we don't have to assume that definition. We only assume that definition to compress time, to say, I got to learn how to die real fast within 80 years or something. Right? So we're identifying with the body because it's a device that we think that can help accelerate our training. But we don't have to identify with the body. We're doing that, again, to compress the time frame, to try and speed up our training. But let's say we want to slow down the training. Well, and we don't need to identify with the body. We don't need to identify with things. We're identifying with things, and even we're identifying with our perception of things to speed up our training program. But we don't have to. What if we slowed it down? What if we slowed it way down? Then what will we identify with? Maybe it would be bliss. Maybe there'd be, if we slow the time frame down, how would we feel? What would the feeling be? What would the natural identification be at that, in this instance? Well, it probably wouldn't be the body. It probably wouldn't be things. It probably wouldn't even be the world. Wouldn't be the world. Wouldn't be the solar system. Probably wouldn't even be the universe. It might be something else, and we're told there is something like bliss that you identify. Say, oh, this is what I want to identify with, given the time frame of this training program. Now the time frame has changed. I decided to change the time frame. So this is an amazing way of looking at the situation. Change the time frame of the training program. Another miracle breakthrough, really. And it just came to me right now as I'm taping. I didn't think of it this morning like this at all. So it shows you the desire to make an effort. You ask the Holy Spirit, I'm going to make an effort. Can you please help us all? And then something comes through like this. Completely changes the whole framework of what we're focusing on. Another a game changer, and we need game changers right now. We absolutely need game changers right now, because what's happening is our desire to finish this program is so intense because we're sick of it and we want to drop it, and our fear of the continuity problem is so intense that we're terrified that we might drop it. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to finish this program by compressing time as much as possible, which means to identify with things which die as much as possible. I mean, die quickly as much as possible, and to have that death happen as much as possible, as quickly as possible. So that is the time frame we're in right now, and so we're headed towards a great rapid dying, as a matter of fact. An ELE, extinction level events, is what we're aiming for, actually. Now, when you change your time frame entirely, like to change the time frame to say, oh, I want to this training program to take a super long time, you know. Okay. Then our identifications will change, and our definitions will change. And so even though all this thing stuff is happening, it doesn't have any effect on us. We still just feel just bliss. Because we don't identify that as dying. Because our time frame, death is going to take, our training program is going to take, you know, so long that all this stuff is not even yet having any effect on me whatsoever. And I'm not trying to identify with any of this stuff at all. So it feels like it's not affecting us. It's like this complete fluff, nothing. Even though it could be happening. But here's another thing. When we choose this different time frame, we will feel like, hey, you know, I want to be someplace that reflects this time frame. And that opens up what I call the death-free realms for us, where everything you see seems to have been there forever, and there's no trace of dying in anything. And yet, theoretically, if these trees lasted for, you know, an unquantified amount of time, that there might begin to be a slight trace of dying or something. But there's none there right now at all. So it opens this up, the death-free realms entirely, you see. It opens it up. Just one second. So this is a miracle breakthrough. This is a miracle breakthrough. And in the nick of time, so we can decide, hey, I want to change the time frame. That's all. I decided to change the time frame. And of course people say, oh, well, we're gonna go on ahead of you then. We'll finish way before you finish. But you say, no, wait a minute though. In the back of my mind, something tells me that there is no finishing of this training program. So all that's going to happen to you who want to try and finish fast is you will suffer immense suffering and misery, etc., trying to bring this training program to a conclusion. You see? But you won't bring it to a conclusion. So it's not true that those who decide to change the time frame of the training program to unquantified amounts of time are somehow falling behind. They're not falling behind. They're actually solving the continuity problem. That's why Jesus said that the last will be first and the first will be last. Those who want to finish first will end up be the last ones to return to have their continuity problem solved. And those who want to finish last will be the first to have the continuity problem solved. Okay, do you get it now? Meaning those who choose the slowest training program will be the ones who get the continuity problem solved first. Because they'll be identifying them with bliss. And they'll say, hey, Everything's stable. There's not a I'm not scared of reality anymore. There's no fear of discontinuity or disorientation. There's none. So they drop the training program altogether, and they are aware of reality as it is. So they're the first. You see how that works? Well, I got up this morning and I said, you know, I don't feel so great, but we have to have a breakthrough today. I didn't think that's possible. I didn't feel like it's possible, but I said, you know, you gotta try. And split the day into half, up to 3 o'clock is half, and then the second half. So we have to at least have a breakthrough in the first half of the day. And then we have to have, you know, try for a second one in the second half. Win both halves of the day. So most people in the world are thinking that their salvation is near because they think their death is near. And they think that this, not only their death, but the end of this training program is near because there's going to be this mass suffering and death, which will finally teach spirit how to die. And it's going to happen fast, condensed. That's what the mind is telling us. So most people think, oh yeah, we're about to be saved that way. But the wise are saying, no, that you're just about to suffer another terrible disillusionment. You find out the training program doesn't work. And all of that was for naught. And of course, those who keep believing in it will find themselves in some place imagining themselves to this is the new reality, and that they're new prime creators, and they'll put on that pretense for a while. But that pretense doesn't last, and eventually this sickening feeling comes in of ennui and something's wrong. I just feel like something's just wrong. I don't know what's wrong. And that'll grip them, and then they'll, you know, realize, wow, maybe I didn't succeed in the training program. So, you know, right now, instead of winning the day, win the half day. Win the half day. And then if you won the half day, try to win the next half day. So we're trying to win this half day right here. Now it's funny because it seems like the last thing we want is to have the training program extended, right? It seems counterintuitive, doesn't it? But now we're seeing that's the answer. We think, no, we want to finish the training program. Let's get it over with. We don't realize the problem is the continuity problem. It's not the training program, because that doesn't, of course, that will never work. It's the continuity problem is our problem. And the more we try to end the training program fast, the worse the continuity problem gets. And the faster we try to end the training program. It's a vicious circle we're stuck in right now in the world, a very vicious circle. Very vicious circle. It's spiraling down the drain. Tighter and tighter and tighter. Faster, faster, faster. More and more fear. Faster, faster, faster. More and more fear. Faster, faster, faster. More and more fear, etc. Now, you know, in other times, it wasn't quite as fast. Other places, etc. Not quite as intense. Although at times it would get very intense too. Absolutely. But let's say you find yourself in where people are not so intensely identified with the body and dying and everything. Does that mean they're going towards enlightenment? No, it doesn't. It just means that they have not yet tired of the training program to the extent that they want to finish it. So the idea of the noble savage, as it were, primitive, as if they're closer to God, is not true at all. It's not true at all, because they're still going in the wrong direction. They haven't worked it through and seen the whole situation and said, oh, what I need is to expand the training program to an unquantified amount of time and let the Holy Spirit do that. Because the question is, if we have this unquantified amount of time, how do we bring the training program to an end? The Holy Spirit collapses all time. Collapses all time. So the Holy Spirit's able to expand all to time and collapse time without any problem whatsoever. So we're making these sea level changes in our orientation right now, which is essential because the world is going off the rails. It's going off the rails. It's like that train in Spain. The trains in Spain go around the bend too fast. And it's like the closer we get to the bend, the hairpin turn, the faster we're going. Because we say, we want to end it now. We want to end it now. Faster, faster, faster. Let, you know, knowing that we're going to go off the rails, but we think that by going off the rails, that's going to solve our problem. It's like the comet coming in towards the sun. Faster, faster, closer it gets. Faster, 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 so fast. You know, we're like a comet going towards the sun right now. It's funny that the way of the psyche of the world, the focus of the world, is like a comet, and here comes Comet Ison in at the same time. You know, there's a synchronicity there that is something to pay attention to. Faster, 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 and we hope we'll just finish the training, we'll learn how to die, we'll just break up, we'll be annihilated, and then we'll be resurrected. Out of that momentum of that, we'll be resurrected as the new prime creator, and we never had to deal with the continuity problem. Because the continuity problem is actually, we're more scared of that than anything. We're more scared of the continuity problem than anything. Death is a trifle for us, or the death of form is a trifle for us. But spiritually, we're saying, oh my, we're afraid of being disoriented forever. So we weigh those two. We say, oh well, let's see if we can go off the rails. Let's go. So instead of slowing down as we're going towards this turn, quick, you know, hairpin turn, instead of slowing down, we're going faster and faster and faster. And we're not thinking about slowing the training program down. No, because the boogeyman of the continuity issue seems to be chasing us. We say, we got to go faster. But if you take the right spiritual path and you become aware of the Holy Spirit explanation, explaining to you, then you come to this point now, you say, no, what I need is to slow the training program down, way, 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 way down. And of course the ego says, oh, but then you'll take a long time to finish it. And I say, no, 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 no. By slowing it down to a miraculous extent, the continuity problem will be solved, and I realize I don't need the training program at all. It was just a crazy whim, and it can never succeed anyway. That's what will actually happen. And the ego will never tell you that. The world will never tell you that. Only the Holy Spirit will tell you that. And then those that it tells, they pass it on. They pass it on. And say, share it. Share it with the world. So this is such a game changer. I don't know what to say next. Sure, there'll be something. Maybe another breakthrough. Why not? Why not? Why not? The first will be last, and the last will be first. The first will be last, and the last will be first. Oops, what does oops stand for? I forgot. OOPS. Well, there's only one problem, and that's the continuity problem. I forgot what OOP stands for. Maybe someone can remember. Oh, only one problem to solve. Only one problem to solve. Only one problem to solve. Whoops. Okay, that's what it is. That's what it is. Oops. Only one problem to solve. Only one problem. to solve. All right. So, here we go. We're in the process of winning the first half of this day. And we'll see what the second half of the day is. Maybe I'll come back with something else then. All right. Very great. That's it for this video.